In the last couple of years, there has been a huge increase in demand from all the old tech, from retro gaming consoles, vintage amplifiers, old computers, tape decks, and many more. Thrift stores have never been so busy, and people are asking for exorbitant prices for some of these old relics on auction sites. But more importantly is that all this equipment is anywhere from 20 to 50 years old and has either just stopped working or is on the brink of its demise. Even when that old tape deck of yours is still playing your favorite tunes or you're still viewing your favorite episodes of The $6 Million Man or The Johnny Carson Show on that old VCR, it's certainly not operating to spec. Furthermore, with every use, you're risking damaging the equipment beyond repair, and the older the component, the greater the risk. If you find yourself with an old broken TV or any other piece of retro or vintage electronics that has stopped working or is just not operating properly, there's a big chance that you can repair it by replacing the capacitors that have come to the end of their life cycle. Pretty much every circuit board and all consumer electronic equipment in your house includes a capacitor in one form or another. A capacitor is a component that basically stores electricity and can supply the stored energy from the electrostatic field just like a battery can supply power. Capacitors are manufactured in many forms, styles, lengths, girths, and from many different materials. Some of the different types of capacitors include ceramic, electrolytic, film, mylar, and there's also something called a supercapacitor. However, the ones that are most likely to fail, especially with age, are electrolytic capacitors. Other things like heat, voltage spikes, and usage further reduce the lifespan of these components. Now, taking apart a real-life example like this electrolytic capacitor, we can see the inside is made of metal films with the dielectric material in the middle. The two metal films are very close to each other, and the dielectric material is not a perfect isolator, so there's a voltage limit. Exceeding this voltage can create a spark and destroy the capacitor. It's also important not to reverse the polarity of these electrolytic capacitors. Also, as the name implies, there's liquid inside these capacitors that's called electrolyte. Over time, slow evaporation of the electrolyte occurs, and this is exacerbated by high temperature. Without getting into complex knowledge on capacitors, it's important to note that capacitors create a form of resistance which we call capacitive reactance, which is the complex impedance of a capacitor whose value changes with respect to the applied frequency. Well, I digress. But basically, capacitors have resistance, and what you need to know is that the older they become, the more they dry up, and the more heat they're exposed to, the higher this resistance is, and the less the capacitor can retain the voltage. In most of my restorations, I demonstrated this by using a tester on some of the old capacitors I removed from all sorts of equipment. You can see that although the capacitors had not blown or burnt yet and looked fine to the eye, they had both high ESR and voltage loss and testing way off the microfarad reading. What this means is that the capacitor can no longer perform its duty, it can no longer filter voltage properly or provide the proper voltage to the next component. Needless to say, this can cause a slew of problems like a washed out image in a DVD player, a harsh and adjustable image in a VCR, bad audio, or plain and simply, a dead unit. Of course, I always get the one person in the comments to tell me, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. Well, let me put it this way. If my roof was 30 years old and not leaking yet, should I wait for a leak to replace it, especially when I intend to build a new kitchen, risking damage? If you have an old computer or device that has irreplaceable or extremely hard to source ICs, the last thing you want to do is keep using it, risking a blown capacitor that could lead to overvoltage or damage those ICs. And if you think you're safe because you stored it away in a box somewhere and not using it, think again. Capacitors can leak with age. A perfect example is the original Xbox. Many had them stored away only to find damaged motherboards from leaked clock capacitors that were only 15 to 20 years old. Well, if you're looking for that relic in the thrift store or at various garage sales, or intend to keep that special console or computer from when you were a kid, or just enjoy listening to your collection of different music formats on your vintage stereo, consider changing the capacitors or getting the right person to do it. Doing so will ensure to keep the history alive while letting you enjoy the nostalgia of simpler times for many years to come. Thanks for watching.